Access to COVID-19 vaccines has been a bit of a problem for third world countries, including Uganda, with the COVAX facility that was established by the World Health Organization not living up to its reputation in enabling African countries acquire the vaccines. The Finance Minister, Matia Kasaija, has today says government is sourcing up to $70 million, that's approximately 230 billion Uganda shillings, to be able to establish a COVID-19 vaccine manufacturing factory in the country. Let's have the details.
Finance Minister Matia Kasaija was appearing before the Parliament Task Force on COVID-19 after members on the committee questioned why the government is wasting money in other activities against COVID-19, yet there is less impact. He said the government needs $14 million as part payment to procure material to start this factory.
The following principles were agreed to guide the emergency funding requirements. One, the identified activities should be of emergency nature for combating COVID-19 within the next 6 months, July to December 21. Two, avoid duplication of activities that are already financed in the normal budget for financial year.
Members of the committee say the government should consider paying off the 2.2 trillion shillings required to procure COVID-19 vaccines to immunize 21 million people and free the economy, which is now limping.
But these issues are saying now dealers will not vanish in this business, and they are making money, and these are the problems we are facing. So, doctor, what you are saying might be true, but the situation here are those who think that are working with the World Health Organization officials in Geneva to steal money and make people suffer. These are the deals within the ministry.
Buhweju County Member of Parliament Francis Mwijushe notes that instead of government spending the money on activities that do not give a permanent solution to the fight against COVID-19, all the money should go into buying the vaccines.
In June 2020, the government had spent 5.7 trillion shillings. 5.7 as of June 2020. The minister is talking about 4 trillion shillings. So I want to know who is telling us the truth and who is telling us a lie. Mr. Minister, how much money exactly have we spent? And even then, this 4 trillion you are talking about, has government just provided it or you have already spent it?
Total money spent, as Honorable Juche says, is beyond 4 trillion. And this is what we would call fire brigading. The problem is still here. The ultimate remedy for this problem is vaccination. And vaccination needs less than 4 trillion. That's the biggest point we are having. Why don't we plan for getting our people vaccinated so that they have what we call a herd immunity? Then we open up the country, people go back to their normal lives, we free the economy, because now this virus has held the economy hostage.
He recommended that the government focuses on looking for the required funds to vaccinate the people.
At cabinet level, we would be rethinking that you'll be discussing about only one thing, vaccination. Let us look at what's going on in the whole world. You know, it's only yesterday, the other day, I was watching a football. I'm a football fan. Thousands are in a football stadium and they are watching football without masks. Why? Because they have managed to vaccinate a certain minimum number of people, and therefore there is herd immunity.
We are here to look for solutions. The solution I see myself, and which we should all focus, there are two. One in the interim, but eventually to help us get out, get into Jerusalem. The question of we manufacturing our own vaccine. Just hold on, yes, that's a long term.
The Member of Parliament for West Budama South, Dr. Emmanuel Otala, proposed that the government pays the cost of COVID-19 patients admitted in both private and government hospitals, since both health facilities charge the same amount, which is too high. Otala was supported by Bugweri County Member of Parliament Abdul Katuntu, who stressed that since the public hospitals have low capacity to take up all the COVID patients in the intensive care unit, the government needs to work with private facilities.